Alright, today we're going to be taking apart the original NES controller. It's actually pretty interesting inside. There are six Phillips head screws along the back. And once you get those screws out, the back casing just pops out. You can see the little grooves inside for organizing the wires. And then this right here is the integrated circuit. This is kind of the brains of the controller. It's a gatekeeper of sorts. It keeps the button presses all under control. And then you can see up here in the top, there's these two little brackets that kind of hold the cable in place, so when you pull on it, it doesn't put any stress on the controller. I'm going to go ahead and lift the circuit board away from the controller itself. And you can see how simple it is. It's actually really cool. So each time you press down one of the little buttons, it connects the little black spots on the board, which connects two wires, and that's what goes to the integrated circuit and controls the actual controller itself. So if you want to wire together other buttons, right there is where you want to solder them on. So I'm going to, when I build my giant controller here in a couple weeks, that's what I'm going to do. Obviously, you can always take off the buttons and clean them out. These are getting kind of be a collector's item, so cleaning them is probably a good decision. Anyway, if you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like if this video helped you, and don't forget to subscribe. It does mean a lot to me. I hope to see you around. Thanks for watching.